how that, what happens when it sends me what you said it's going to send me. So,
right. So now Roosevelt and I are testing the recording feature. Roosevelt is going to get a recording of this blab sent to his email box, and he's going to be able to listen to the quality of the MP3 and the MP4, and he's also going to get an embed code. The embed code will allow you to take it to your WordPress site or even Medium. If you're using Medium to blog on and write on, you can put that embed code in it, and it will take that embed code, will not take you to a live link that is happening in real time, but what it will take you to the recorded link, which is what this is. This recording will stay on Blab for perpetuity. So forever.
So talk a little bit about the host etiquette, because I've watched some, like I said, I've watched some blab. People will start, the host will start blasting people in the comment section because you may get some trollers, what they call trollers. Mm-hmm. Use a lot of profanity and all of that. When I do my show, first order of business, no profanity or I will block you forever. I'm not one to, you know, to be messing around with people. Right. But talk a little bit about host etiquette.
Host etiquette is a busy, you're sitting in a busy chair. You have all the controls to the blab. So you can block people. You can let people in. You can communicate people in the chat writing, or you can communicate them by direct communication like this to answer, you know, a question that they may have or pose. So you can do several things. That's why sometimes if you're going to do a show, it's suggested that maybe you have a sidekick or someone on your other side, a trusted resource that maybe can watch the flow of the writings and help you to disseminate that information, because, you know, you're here, your eyes are here, you're trying to make eye contact with your guest, whatever it may be. So a practice that you might want to try is to have a host sitting with you, and they can kind of monitor the chat and things like that. And then you ultimately have control to, you know, get rid of a comment you don't like or anything else. So, for example, go over to your right, Roosevelt, and see where at Bones Trust said, okay, thanks, all makes sense.
Right.
Okay, you see that? Click on that icon.
And his icon.
Click on that icon in the right-hand side. Now, right. you'd be able to go ahead and delete that comment. You should be able to delete that comment.
I don't see the delete. I pulled up his profile.
Yeah, just hover over the icon itself.
Oh, you mean not the triangle icon?
Yeah. You can do that triangle, and then you can delete that comment.
Oh, see? Okay, got you.
So if someone has written something, and sorry, I think his name is Steve. Sorry, Steve. I'm just using you as a test. So, thank you, Steve. By the way, for being our test guinea pig. You can, if someone writes something inappropriate in your comment section, or maybe they're link dropping or something like that, you can say, hey, listen, guys, you know, you can promote your stuff on my blab if you want, but I haven't asked you. Usually the good course of being good stewards of the community is to ask first, please. You know, it's like, may I drop a link, or hey, I have something of value that aligns with what Roosevelt is saying. Hey, Roosevelt, can I drop my link to something? It really aligns with what you're saying. And Roosevelt may say, yeah, go ahead, drop that link in there, please. I'd like to research that information too. Boom. Maybe it's an author or a coach or something on the
Mike, content. What's the real problem with letting people promote themselves in the chat?
It's all, you know, this is your blab, this is your space, and you set your guidelines and your swim lanes. So you decide what it needs to look like for you. And that's for anyone in the chat, anyone listening, this is your blab. You decide what you want it to look like. And that's really what the blab team wants to empower us, the community members, to have. It's like, you decide if you want PG, PG-13, rated R content material, you decide. Okay. If it aligns with you and your listeners and your community, put it out front. This is kind of how my structure and my place is. You decide what it looks like.
Well, you know, the thing about putting it out front, there's no way that people will know if they just happen to pop into your blab what your guidelines are, unless you keep repeating it.
Well, you know, and some people do that. Some people have, you know, just put it on a Word document or a little Word document or a text document onto the side. And it's like, hey, here's my swim lane. I just keep putting it in the chat. Here you go. Here's kind of my rules of my playground.
Okay.
My sandbox. You know, and maybe you have to put that in there every 5, 10, or 15 minutes, whatever. You're going to have an hour-long show, let's say. maybe you have that written disposition in, you know, four sentences. You know, PG, keep it PG-13, blah, blah, blah. Maybe this, that, again, it's your blab. You can decide how you want it. And you're right. People, as a community, or it's like a networking group. People are going to come into your circle and come out of your circle. They may not know what you're talking about. Maybe it's by, you know, your information that you have as your topic. Maybe they find interest in it and they come in. Maybe they just listen for a minute and hover. Maybe they get out. Maybe they get involved. Maybe they don't. It's really, truly a networking community that's pretty active at times. And they're, you know, you might run into trolls. And I hope you don't, but they are out there and people want to upset other people and not play nicely. And that's just the way life goes.
Well, let's define a troll.
Okay.
What is considered a troll?
Well, I think that's truly dependent on the person and how thick your skin is. I really do. A troll can be someone that upsets you or maybe is profane and you're not a profane person. Maybe you're on a business topic and they're in the chat and they're talking about, I don't know, something completely non-related to your stuff. Again, it's up to your skin, how thick you want someone in your sandbox to play in, what you will tolerate. And it's up to you to decide what that guideline, that swim lane, for lack of a better word, is. You just decide.
So let's say you get somebody who puts, say, inappropriate comments, like they put, you know, racial slurs or say something like that.
Yeah.
Where would I go to just block that person?
Up top, you'll see you'll see all our little icons.
Yes.
You can hover over somebody's picture and just blink, kick them out. Just X them out. That's it. Don't talk about them. Don't feed the troll. Don't say anything like
that.
Yeah,
I mean, but does that only block them for this blab or for future blabs?
This only blocks them for this blab. They cannot come in here and bug you on camera and request to come in, and they cannot bug you in the written text.
Okay.
But they can still listen. And they can follow you, or they can appear in another blab.
Right.
You don't have a complete block and kick out just because you didn't get along with them. Someone may align with them just because you didn't align with them. It's like life.
Right.
And that's what the blab team has kind of developed. It's like, we understand that you didn't align with them, but maybe John and Judy aligned with them. And you guys don't align with each other on the subject matter.
Right. Like on business hangouts, we can block somebody permanently so they can't register for any of your future shows. So, you know, you just take care of them with one swipe.
Right. That feature is not here
because
the blab team has taken a different viewpoint of it.
Right.
You know, hopefully everyone plays nicely together. But, you know, doggone it, we're all people and we all make mistakes and we all don't align and jive with each other's thoughts, processes, and acumens in life.
Right.
It's just the way life is. So that's kind of handling the trolls. I hope you don't run into any problems on the platform. I hope it's all nice and swell for you guys. But again, I can't see the future, dude.
I have watched Blabs for the last couple of weeks and there haven't been a lot of trolls and everybody handles them differently, you know.
Yeah.
And like you say, it's your show. My thing is just, I don't want to interrupt the conversation, which I think a lot of hosts, I've seen a lot of hosts do, because they're responding to something that was said in the chat that's off topic.
Yeah.
And that to me disrupts, you know, your show. So either you ignore them or you just, like you say, pull up the triangle and block them and get rid of them completely without telling people I'm going to block this person or I'm going to kick them out. I mean, that's not what the show is about. You know, you should try to maintain focus.
We're apples and oranges from where you're coming from G+, from Google Hangouts. So it's a new area to get used to. You may find some really great follows and very active community members that may follow you over to your other things.
Well, I understand
And you might be able to converge those two swim lanes and really find a very active community. So at least I hope that's
happen. From what I've seen, I like this community. It's fast paced. It's a lot more interactive.
Yeah.
And I don't mind that.
Yeah. So I hope that works for you. Let's see, what else can I tell you real quick? As Daniel said, if someone has a question, they can highlight the question. I like that feature about Blab. You can /. I always call it /, because I'm old school. There's /// and /// I call it /, but it is called //Q. Then type your question. It'll highlight as Daniel has shown you over here on the right-hand side. You can also, anyone inside that is working currently inside the quadrants can change the topic. So /, the word topic altogether, and then type whatever it is. It will change the topic.
Now, how often do you flip through, as a host, how often do you flip through the mentions and the questions? Just so that you can, that way I think you can really, you know, give a shout out to somebody that mentions you and you can immediately see all the questions. How often do you flip through that, or do you just keep it on all?
I think it's dependent truly on the host, it's how much multitasking, as I call it, you would like to do. And you're comfortable with. If you want to say, hey guys, I'm going to take a second here, let me read through the comments, I'm going to scroll up to the top, make sure I didn't miss anything, and okay, yeah, we talked about that point or whatever, or oh, here, Daniel had this question I want to answer, let's talk about this for just a moment and bring it back to topic. Again, it's your show, however you would like to, and if you'd like to have a co-host in the seat here with you that sometimes scans something and says, oh, Daniel had this really great, you know, as you guys maybe come to that pregnant pause in your blab, and it's like, hey, Roosevelt, Daniel over here on the right-hand side made a really great point about XYZ, and then maybe that takes you in, aligns with your subject matter, and you speak to it for a few moments. I don't know.
Talk about the qualifications of a co-host.
it's whomever you align with, obviously, as the host. It's some people like to have someone that's looking at the other side of the issue in a challenging way. Some people like to have a host that aligns with them. Someone likes to have a host for comedic relief. Someone just simply likes to have a host as an admin assistant, and they look over there and they're just reading it, you know, reading comments, and they're putting it. So there's lots of ways you could create your space here. Again, I can't emphasize it enough. It's your blab. You can do with it as you will. It's your space to create content and have fun with it, you know, and learn. Have fun first and learn. It's like how I tell my daughter always, you know, like, have fun first in life and let's learn something. You know, we're, you know, right now it's volleyball, you know, and I'm the co-coach for a team of 11-year-old young ladies from 10 to 13. So all that said, it's always fun first, and then we learn the skill sets of what we're trying to get done.
Yeah, I think all of this should be fun, or you just don't do it, because you don't need another, you know, something else to cause stress in your life. And all of, you know, these platforms are great, and you just have to pick the ones that do what you want them to do for your needs, and that's it. You know, you can't, I try not to mimic other people. I do what I enjoy doing. And if people want to join into that, that's fine. Cause you're not going to satisfy everybody.
No, it's like a radio station, man. You're not going to have that song playing that you like in rotation all the time, or that musical subset of, you know, radio station. And maybe it's talk radio. They're not always going to be talking about what you like. So, yeah, you're absolutely correct. Television, same thing with television. They're not always going to be something on any particular channel you're really aligning with, or you want to watch. And sometimes you just click the dang thing off and you go read a book, or you go outside and enjoy our amazing universe that is available to us.
So. Daniel's old 1-2 mentioned Manicam, and if Manicam doesn't work with iOS, I can't use Manicam, Daniel.
Roosevelt. You can research and explore XSplit as well as Cam Twist.
Yeah.
If you want that lower thirds, if you want some of those features that Daniel and some others have, some of them like that, you know, because it, you know, some of them, I do know one gentleman on the platform I've really become fast friends with. He's got it just scrolling his website, and he serves the community of pet owners. So he's actually gotten some sales. He doesn't, you know, doesn't say go to my website. It's just there's a scrolling lower third, and people have clicked on it. He's actually gotten some sales for pet supplies and, you know, just all things. And he's a dog rescue person and stuff like that. So, you know, he's gotten a little bit of sales through his website for that, which goes back into his dog rescue stuff. So, you know, some people use it to promote their book, their authors, or, you know, some people have had all kinds of fun with it and creating neat cubes and spinning heads and just very creative stuff out there. So, you know.
Well, I've the only reason I've been looking at something like that, again, going back to Business Hangouts on Air, you can do the screen share. And I know on Blab, they're working on coming out with a screen share feature. Because I cover the auto industry a lot. You know, I review cars, shoot video of cars, attend new car press launches. And I'd like to be able to easily pull in a car, for instance. Like, I get a new car every week to drive and shoot video of. So I'd love to be able to pull a car in that's sitting in outside of the house, for instance, and say, okay, let's talk about the car. What is it on this particular vehicle that you want to see right now?
Yeah.
And if you want to see the inside of the glove box, I can go over to the car and show you the inside of the glove box easily. So
yeah, and that's the neat thing about, you know, Blab creating the mobile set. You know, on Android, yes, you still have to go through Google,
right?
Chrome, excuse me. But on iOS, they do have their own proprietary app, and they have it in beta as well as the iOS app. And if you're going to use your iPhone, I would encourage you to have both beta and the iOS on there. The iOS gets updated, but not at the frequency speed rate that the beta gets updated at, because they literally try and break it all the time. They're actually trying to break and figure out what the problem subset may be on Blab, so they can always make the platform better for the end user experience. So
yeah, I've been using the beta on the mobile to do that. You know, I do a lot of live streaming. I've been live streaming since the mid 90s, really early 90s, when we did live broadcasts on a 20. I don't know whether you'll remember this, but remember 2400 and 5400 baud modems.
Oh yeah.
The dial-ups. So I cut my live streaming teeth on that kind of technology. So
nice.
So I've watched the technology progress and get to the point where you can walk around with a mobile phone and do a live broadcast. I find that amazing. Small business people don't really appreciate what they carry around on their waist, in their pocket, or in their purse. And they always want to be, well, I want to figure out a way to make enough money to be on television. You can have your own show for free.
That's really some of the heads of state of Blab would like to see, that this type of continuity and programming come to this platform and see what we all create. So there's all sorts of opportunities, you know, for everyone to create some really fun content. And it could be based around spirituality, religion, sex, money, business, you know, really, truly, the world's your oyster. And with all transparency, the Blab team is trying to figure out, how do we identify that maybe PG-13 or after 10 o'clock PM or the Adult Swim segment? What does that look like? You know, it's having some growing issues and growing pains, and they realize it. And and they're trying to figure out how to help and how to help create and how to identify those swim lanes and what it's going to look like. So,
These kinds of platforms give you an opportunity to really be unique and set yourself apart from the competition.
The content that you bring is only from your spoken voice, your spoken word, and your mind. So, you're absolutely correct. You know, your content's going to be different and maybe in the same swim lane as like someone else talking about auto, but your delivery, your depth of knowledge or whatever, how you deliver the content's going to be different from someone else. So that's the fun, neat thing about it. So
what is it that you've been around for a while? I know it hasn't in internet space and time, it's been very, very short. What is it that you particularly enjoy about, say, this Blab platform?
I like that.
As a host.
I think, well, let's talk about the platform as a whole first. I love the fact that the creative minds, you know, I love the story behind Blab. And I love that the creative team, you know, basically got pushed out and said, you guys get out of the office, go work from coffee houses, home, or whatever. And you got 2 weeks to come back with an idea set and let us see what it is. And this Blab was started from Monkey Inferno, which was a think tank in San Francisco, which was a subset of Bebo. So they said, you know, what can we do? And they kind of came back with this idea set of Blab for all intents and purposes. And then they kind of refined it and tweaked it and said, that's really cool. Guys, stop what you're working on. Let's put all of our efforts into this and see what we create. And thus Blab was created. So it's much deeper than that. And the story is much more well told by founder Sean and the CTO and the CFO and other Brittany and other people that are here on the platform. I also like that it gives voice to maybe some opportunities. For example, I've now been part of two fundraising campaigns on Blab. One was very spontaneous, where they called me in because I have a different microphone set and a full studio setup upstairs. And they're like, you know, we want to test your microphone. Please speak into it, blah, blah, blah. And the other guy had the same style of microphone. He clicked it in and he goes, hey, I like this. Well, a young lady in Florida said, hey, I've got this microphone. I don't like it. We should auction it off. We all laughed. Yeah, let's auction it off. Well, originally he was supposed to be interviewing someone that's doing work in Africa that creates clean drinking water through a system, through a gadget. And for every $10 American raised into his charity, it supplies 1 year of clean drinking water for one person in Africa. Well, what happened was spontaneously, we said, let's auction off the microphone. Well, sure, we did. And in 22 minutes, we raised over $1,000 for this charity, unscripted, unprepared, on everything. The microphone got sold and bid on, and it was only $120 microphone.
Yeah, ended right.
Up raising $400 for this microphone, and Sean, the CEO, bought it, to be quite honest, a Blab. And so she ships it to Sean. It creates a really great harmonic community event, and people talked about it for several days there afterwards. That's one example. The second example was this past weekend, I was part on this past Friday, I was part of what we call blabathon.org. We actually raised $4,000 real time between like 3 and 10:30, you know, Eastern Standard Time, whatever it was, for Jamie, a young boy on the platform here who has cerebral palsy.
Right, and, I've seen him.
Yeah, Jamie. So we raised $4,000 for him. We're getting him a MacBook Pro, a 13-inch Retina MacBook Pro, and it's actually in Vegas right now with the guys that hosted and started the idea set, and they're actually building up with some speak-to-text speech products so he can have Dragon on there and some other things. And getting, you know, that's the goodwill side of it that I see, Blab. That's the philanthropic, helping others out in the community. It was completely community sourced. Everything on Blab was done transparently. It was, the website was created with people. The copywriting was done. The website itself was created real time on Blab. The people came out. We had singers. We had people volunteering. We had people matching funds. It was all done real time on this platform transparently.
We
hit our mark, which was really great. And I think that's one power of this community that I've not seen on Facebook. I haven't seen on Google+. The other thing I like about this platform is I see the ambassadors like myself. I'm not paid by Blab. I don't work for Blab. I'm just an advocate of Blab. I really like and see what my experiences to date have been all positive. Let me caveat that because I know other people have had things on here happen.
Right.
My personal experience has been of the positive nature. I like the advocacy. I love the fact that the team are active listeners. They listen real time. I can type at help in here, and for Khan or Sean or Brittany or Jason, someone's going to come in and say, what do you need? You know, what is it? So I love that they're active listeners. They're real time listeners, and they will come in and offer and try and help as much as they can. So
I popped in a Blab last night. As a matter of fact, you're talking about fundraising, and they had a GoFund account set up for this young lady who was fighting cancer. And, you know, I joined in and man, I donated $50 to the cause.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and there's another one that's starting this weekend. There's St. Baldrick's is happening this weekend around our country. A lot of people go shave their heads for cancer to raise money for cancer kids. And there's a young lady yesterday. She was on here. She was trying to get traction. And I'm like, okay. You know, she was frustrated. I jumped in. I'm like, here's some idea sets of what we've had with other successful Blabs and raising funds. Let me gift you this. Well, I was talking to her, and people that follow me can typically see when they're scanning, if on Blab, on the front page as we're speaking, other people see me and say, hey, I know Mike, let's go find out what he's talking about. Or I know David, what are they talking about over there? Or I know such and such, let's go see what happened. One over about a 60-minute period, I was in there giving her idea sets on how to create copy content, how to schedule her blab, things like this, because she was so new to the platform, it was overwhelming for her. And then next thing you know, someone else comes in that's a graphic designer, said, hey, I can help you with this. Let me do some graphic design for you so you can put it up on your webpage, Facebook, your Facebook profile, stuff like that. So the community came together to help for another philanthropic, cancer-driven disposition. And right. They came forward openly, transparently, and said, let me help. Here's what you should do. Let me help. Here's what you do. Hey, let me teach you about Hootsuite and how to schedule tweets out, because it's free and it will keep rotating while you're sleeping and the information can keep going. So
now you just gave me an idea. I have a lot of paraphernalia from car company events that I go on. You know, they give us all kinds of stuff. I mean,
sure.
And I was thinking about in the future putting that up on eBay and selling it, but now you've given me an idea. Say, okay, let's have an auction for these items, and we'll donate the proceeds to whatever, you know, whatever.
Sure. I pick select. Three or something. You know, yeah, pick two,
how,
pick one.
How do you set something up like that to receive the proceeds?
Well, in our case, what we did with our situation was we had a PayPal account and John hosted everything and John ate all the fees of all that $4,000 that came into his account. So that 3.7 or whatever it is percent, he ate that. He's like, you know, I'll open the books. You can transparently see where the money's going to. Anything over 4,000, we're going to also give to the CP, the Cerebral Palsy Foundation. Transparently. We don't care. Here you go. Knock himself out.
Right.
Because we don't have a 501(c)(3), or we don't have a bank account set up yet with blabathon.org. We do have the URL. We have web presence and some other things, but we don't have it in a full package yet to raise money, so we can't get taxed on it and get the licenses and blah, 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 right. blah. So we don't have it fully set up yet. So in our example, in our case, we basically used a pass-through account of PayPal. And we were very transparent. This is going to John's business PayPal account. And he's eating all the fees, by the way, guys. John created the website. He created the awareness. He's here very transparently. And so just please be aware that, you know, John is eating all these fees. That's his gift, along with time and effort and everything else. So that's what we had to do at this point. You know, some people are saying, hey, I'm part of St. Baldrick's, and you just go to this link. And it goes directly into the cancer research fund that I'm working towards. So she doesn't even have to touch the money. It's going straight into an account. Right. So,
but if you're auctioning off something, obviously you're going to have to mail it to the person that purchases it. So.
Right, right. So, you know, in some way, you know, you're going to have to eat the fees, or you're going to have to figure out what that looks like, or are you going to take an administrative disposition out to, you know, if it's a rather large item. It could be, you know, 12, 15, 25 bucks to mail something.
Oh, yeah, I understand. You're right.
So, you know, you may have to have a very clean disclaimer that says, you know, hey, administrative fees are going to be cost for mailing this, or they send you a self-addressed stamped envelope, okay. Or, you know, those are the background operational cycle things that as you start to think about, you know, a philanthropic opportunity, what does it look like? How big is this animal? And those are the questions in a mastermind. You have to kind of start rolling around your head and get some of your friends together over a glass of wine or a beer or something. Just sit there and say, all right, how are we going to handle this? And if I got to mail a fender or whatever, you know, maybe a cleaning kit, you know, that's chemicals or it could be whatever. Right. If it's of weight, you know, how am I going to get this over, you know, to somebody that bid for it in California and I'm in New Jersey? It's going to cost me, you know, 12 or 18 or 15 bucks to mail it. How am I going to account for those costs? Do right. I gift half of it since I'm the charitable donation and that's my donation set, you know, or what do we do? So
you got to mastermind. You've given me an idea that now I've moved away from eBay to find another way to get rid of a lot of this stuff. So,
well, that's cool. If it's, you know, if it resonates in your universe and you've got some stuff like that and you think that'd be a nicer way to handle it, or, you know, maybe you sell half of what you got to help cover the cost of other things, you know, for the freemium items, maybe another way to do it. Maybe you sell two or three or four or five items on eBay, and you take those proceeds and say, hey, those winnings are going towards the fact that I'm going to use them for shipping and handling on my event that I'm going to be auctioning off these items for, right. And then the money got to go to cancer or stuff like that. Or however you want to work it. Again, it's you got to sit down with your friends and your buddies over some time with a mastermind plan and really map it out, because you know we threw it together. We really truly threw it together on this platform, and we were lucky.
Well, it worked.
Quite frankly,
it worked for you. You had the right people at the right time to make it work. So,
you know, God is good. The universe gifted away what we needed to have, and He put all of us together for whatever reason.
That's true,
and it worked.
Well, any more host suggestions? Before, I didn't mean to hog all your time.
You know, no, it's all right. That's all right. You know, Twitter is your great friend on here. If you're trying to drive traffic, you know, you can ask people to tell a little bird, and they'll tweet it. It'll tweet the people that are in the boxes at the time. And so that works. I'm going to, if I can find Mark's, I'm going to maybe give me 1 second here. Let me see.
We have, who is this sitting out there? Brandon, is it Krieger? Hi, Brandon. We're doing a test here. I'm trying to learn how to be a host, as you can see on Blab. Mike happened to pop in when I was having such difficulties trying to get my camera to work.
We got him on, though.
And I couldn't get that to work, so he walked me through the process.
And anybody else listening, in the chat over here, I put, this is Mark's tutorial, Mark Levy. Great guy out of, he's an expat from the UK living in Israel right now. Him and this other young lady, this is just a blog post, but it's a great tutorial on Blab, and I always share this out because I think it's very well done. And it's also updated real time, so whenever they have the fireside chats or the community chats that the CEOs, CTOs, CFOs come together and talk about, they update this document real time, and it's constantly being updated to all the changes in Blab. So I would encourage you to take a look at that, review it. It's got some nice pointers on just the inner workings of Blab. So
I just bookmarked that page. So
I always share this out. I think it's a great resource. Mark's a very nice man, and he's another value leader on the platform. And so I always just share that one out. I always have it.
I appreciate it. Thanks.
Yeah. So, any other questions I can answer for you, man?
No, I have to go back and watch this and see anything else I can come up with. You've given me some good suggestions on things that I can cover.
Cool.
And especially on the donation side, trying to come up with some ideas to support some different groups that, as I have gotten older now, it's time to give back.
however it flows in your universe, man. Yeah. It's all good. It's all good. So enjoy the platform. If you have any problems, at help is your friend in case you get stuck with anything. At help Brittany or Jason. Well, right now I think they're in New York. They just finished Periscope Summit, so they may be flying back today and driving. Jason lives in Toronto and he drove down to New York, and Brittany's based out of San Francisco, and she'll be flying back at some point. Be that as it may, if you type at help, Sean or Furkan or anybody else can jump into the chat with you. So if you get stuck, your camera doesn't work, hopefully it would, and it should. You shouldn't have any other problems right now. Just at help is your friend, and there's a great set of community ambassadors like myself that are out here willing to help too, that have great vast knowledge of the platform. So have fun on Blab. I look forward to seeing what you create, man.
Great. Thanks, Mike. I'm going to shut you out because I understand I have to do that in order to keep the Blab from
going. Don't kick me out. Give it a try. Cut me out.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks, man. I appreciate your time.
See you.
Now, this is Roosevelt, and I've had my first test Blab, and luckily, Mike jumped in to walk me through getting my camera going, which was a real issue. Obviously, if you're going to do a live stream, you have to have video. So I appreciate that. Thank you, Mike. Thanks for all the tips. You can watch the replay. I understand it should post pretty soon. It'll be interesting for me to see what Blab sends me and how I'll be able to use that information that they do send me. But as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive, and I'll see you next.